I am Andrea Lu. I work at the City University of New York Advanced Science Research Center. I'm the Einstein Professor at the CUNY Graduate Center and the Director of the Photonics Initiative. Broadly, we work in the area of metamaterials that are engineered materials that we build from the nanoscale up. And our broad goal is to come up and envision new properties that materials acquire by structuring them at the nanoscale and playing with the degrees of freedom that come from the constituents of these materials. So even if typically we rely on basic materials like glass, silver, gold, silicon, the structuring of these materials at the nanoscale enables us to realize effects that are very different from the constituents that are not available in nature, and it's not just mixing of different materials, but it's more than that. It's an emerging property that comes from this nanostructuring. So fundamentally, our research is really curiosity driven. We love to just ask questions that may seem crazy when we start, and we actually then find a way to address the problem, to understand the new boundaries that come by coming up with new material designs. Again, just posing curiosity-driven questions of what can we do to the scattering of an object, so the visibility of an object, if we coat it with ideal materials that may have properties that are not the usual ones. For instance, an index of refraction near zero. And what we were finding is that you can either start from an object that scatters very little, so it's almost an object with low scattering, and you can make it much brighter than it would be based on its size, or vice versa, you can start from an object that is very bright, that highly visible, and you can make it much less detectable, more transparent, using tailored materials. So over the years, we started from really a curiosity-driven theoretical question to simulations and optimization of engineered materials that can actually achieve these effects, to actually proof-of-concept experiments that show that this is actually possible. We actually were able to derive the fundamental bounds, it's a mathematical result, a trade-off between the bandwidth over which low scattering phenomena can be achieved, the level of scattering reduction we can achieve with the metamaterial cloak, and the size of the object compared to the wavelength. So there are these three parameters that come into play and tell us what's the maximum effect we can achieve for a given object that we start with. This result, on one hand, it's exciting because it tells us what we can do. At the same time, for some of the more sexy applications, tell us that it will be very challenging to get to something that really strikes our imagination, like an invisible man, let's say. There are actually several near-term applications of these technologies. For instance, we work at the moment with wireless communication companies that are very interested in realizing radio-transparent antennas or radio-transparent devices, mechanical struts that do not block the propagation of electromagnetic waves. These are things that we can do practically and that have direct impact. In the past 20 years, the questions that come up continuously evolve. We discover new opportunities. Also, as the fields mature, we see a lot more impact on technologies, on opportunities for pushing the boundaries of wave phenomena for applications that are relevant to all of us.